182,000 Yazidis have sought refuge in Kurdish cities, dwelling in abandoned office buildings like these.
Just behind me are the mountains that lead to Turkey. Turkey is very close, just several kilometers away. And many of the Yazidis who have come here to the northern Iraqi city of Zako say they prefer to go to Turkey. That's because they say they can no longer live with Muslim Arabs.
One Yazidi leader told us hundreds of Muslim neighbors turned against his people when Islamic State fighters arrived in Sinjar.
The Arabic tribes, they joined them and they attacked our villages. They took away our females, children, old men, everything. Even if we got back our homes, we cannot live with the Arabs because they are usually trying to persecute us.
This refugee spent 8 days trapped on Sinjar Mountain. He's a recent Christian convert, so we're protecting identity. Shamo says he witnessed terrorists kill 170 Yazidi men, then take their wives and daughters away to be sold or used as sex slaves. He says he wants nothing to do with Islam because of ISIS and the atrocities committed by Muslims he once considered friends. Shamo says he was attracted to Christianity because of the kindness and generosity of Christians.
I can say only one word about the difference between Islam and Christianity. The difference is the distance between earth and sky and heaven. We're thinking every day why we are not behaving just like the Christians. We really saw a real humanity in their life.
Feeling betrayed by Arab Muslims, the Yazidi refugees are looking to the Kurds and Christians for help.
We're here to show that you have not been abandoned. Knowing that many Yazidis died on Mount Sinjar, lacking clean water, we have taken the initiative to bring water tanks to the Yazidi people so that they would have water on a daily basis in order to drink and survive.
CBN provided 8 tanks, doubling the number of existing water tanks for nearly 4,000 refugees living in these unfinished office buildings.
We've heard that you are in need of blankets. These blankets are gifts and relief to the Yazidi people, from the church in America and from American believers. And people are thinking of you and praying to God for you.
Shamo is thankful and asks that American Christians continue to assist and pray for the Yazidis.
Please, either if you can protect us, provide us an international protection, or take us out of the country because we don't want to give our children and our women anymore. Please pray for the Yazidis people so as to come to Christ just like me.
Changed hearts and lives as CBN partners bring blankets and clean water for life. Living water for eternity.
And we do these things in the name of Jesus Christ.
Gary Lane, CBN News, Zako, Iraq.